Hi friends, this is Mayanak Mishra. Welcome back to my channel. And today I'll be discussing about Poland's official submission for 92nd Academy Awards Corpus Christi, directed by Jan Komasa. This is a religious film, but this is also a liberal film. Okay, so this film deals with the ideologies of redemption and salvation. So these are very important topics and also complex topics, and this film deals with these topics. Okay, so let me start with a little bit about the story. So this film chronicles the events in the main character Daniel's life. So Daniel is a murder convict. So previously he has murdered one boy, and he is right now kept in a juvenile detention center. And there, you know, his spiritual awakening happens, and he is inspired by Father Thomas. He prays the religious songs, and he thinks himself as a priest. He wants to be a priest. His entire world revolves around his dream to be a priest. Okay, so this film, you know, this film is about a simple person's life, and it throws some questions to the audiences. Like, does the background of a person really matter? So if somebody has a black past, so for example, if somebody is an ex-convict who has committed a crime, so isn't he eligible to pray before God? Can he be not a believer of God? Can't he be the son of God? So this film throws this kind of I won't say uncomfortable, but this kind of controversial questions. And this is a liberal film, you know, so everybody can ask these questions. If somebody has done some mistake, can't he be a religious person? Can't he be a priest? This film is about that, you know. So Daniel has committed a crime. He has murdered a boy, and he is kept in a juvenile center. And then he wants to be a priest. He is inspired by Father Thomas's prayers and, you know, religious songs. And then, you know, he is shifted to the other side of Poland in a small town where, you know, he is destined to work in a sawmill. So he reaches that village, and then he enters the sawmill, but then he comes back, and he waits in a hilltop, and he sees the church nearby. He enters that church for a mass, and then he fakes his identity. He befriends Martha, who is the daughter of the sexton, and he says that he is a priest. So he acts as an impostor, but he has some different background, right? So then when he Martha asks him to show the clergy collar, and he has already stolen the clergy collar from Father Thomas. So he shows that, and then he is taken to the vicar, the existing vicar. And the vicar then recruits him temporarily as a priest in that church. So he is recruited there, but the sexton, who is Lydia, she has mixed feelings. So she doesn't accept him quite, you know, wholeheartedly, but yeah, he is given the job of the priest. So Daniel starts conducting the regular works in that church, the prayers and the masses, and his unorthodox behavior wins people's heart. So he has a kind of, he shows, very unorthodox kind of behavior, liberal behavior. It's not typically that of a priest. and people love that. And in the meantime, he comes to know about a story in that village, about a real, it's not a story actually, it's a real event. Seven youngsters, including the driver, passed away in an accident a few months back. And the entire town still keeps mourning about the losses of the lives. And everybody holds the driver responsible for that accident. They believe that it was the driver's fault, and because of that the youngsters passed away. But Daniel is not convinced, and he believes that an accident cannot be somebody's fault. Accident is an accident. And you know, the driver was not allowed to be buried in the same cemetery like the other youngsters. So this is an injustice. He of course he doesn't like it, and he gets Martha, who is now his friend, by his side. Together they visit the widow of the driver, and she is absolutely upset, and because there is a reason for that, because all the people, all the inhabitants previously sent very offensive letters accusing his husband, the driver, as a responsible person for this accident. So she shuts the door, and she doesn't want to talk to Daniel in that matter. So Daniel, later on, he keeps making the townspeople understand, he tries to convince them that an accident is an accident. The mayor of that small town, he comes to Daniel and he says that, whatever happens, it is bed rest now, and you should forget that. We cannot allow the driver's remains to be buried in that cemetery. But Daniel keeps trying, keeps convincing people, and ultimately Daniel and Martha are able to convince the townspeople that the cremated remains of the driver should be buried in the same cemetery as others, as the youngsters who also passed away during that accident. So at the funeral ceremony, the Father Thomas, who is the priest of that juvenile center, he appears and he sees Daniel. So Daniel is caught. He says that you are an ex-convict. You are a convict. You cannot be a priest. It is not right. So he catches Daniel, and in the farewell mass, Daniel was conducting the farewell mass. And in the meantime, in the middle of the mass, he puts off his vestment and he walks off. Everybody is sad, but that's how he walks off, and he is again brought back to the same juvenile center. And in that center, the brother of that boy whom he murdered, he is staying. And there is a fight between Daniel and the brother of that boy, and Daniel wins that fight, and he is allowed to walk free. So this is the story. But the film actually deals with a very important issues of redemption and salvation. Everybody has the right to be redeemed before God. The God is the Redeemer. The Lord, our beloved Lord, Jesus Christ, He is the Redeemer. So anybody who has committed a crime or sin, he also has the right to redeem himself, for salvation, to be a priest, to be a religious person. So this film is a very liberal film, the amazing screenplay, very well researched screenplay by Matthews Pesuiz. He researched for about 5-7 years regarding this subject, because this is a very common subject in rural Poland. wherein many young people become imposter as a priest. They impersonate a priest and they get recruited. So this is not a very common, very uncommon incident in rural Poland. And the Matthew's Pesui's screenplay portrays that. The cinematography by Piotr Sobosinski Jr. Piotr Sobosinski Jr. Is very nice. The way he captured the beautiful rural Polish landscape. He used desaturated color palette on the images. It's very nice, very nice photography, cinematography, and the acting is by Daniel is played by Bartok Bilenia. He is tough but tender. He is what can I say? He is irreligious. At the same point of time, he is liberal. There are a lot of ups and downs combinations, but the way he has portrayed the character is very dynamic portrayal of the character. Eliza resemble as Martha is good, very good acting. As Father Thomas, Mr. Simlat, he has done very good portrayal of Father Thomas. Overall, the characters play a good role, nice acting, played very nice. Cinematography is fine, direction is very dynamic. Screenplay is restrained, at the same point of time very detailed, very well researched. So this is a good film from Poland. It was nominated for Best International Feature Film at 92nd Academy Awards. It won 11 Polish Academy Awards. It was screened in Venice Film Festival 2019, as well as Toronto International Film Festival 2019. A lot of good reviews. It was screened across the world. So I think you have seen it. If you haven't seen it, then please see the film. It is a it is a religious film, but very liberal film. Throws a lot of questions. It will evoke thoughts. It will inspire people for art, towards artistic endeavor. I think you have already seen this film, and if you haven't, then please see this film. Please subscribe to my channel if you like this video, and please wait for the next one until I make the next video. As of now, thank you and bye for watching this video. Thank you. Bye.